हेलो एवरीवन, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट न्यू चैप्टर लेजर एंड डिस्कस अबाउट इंड्यूस एब्सॉर्प्शन, स्पॉन्टेनियस इमिशन एंड स्टिमुलेटेड इमिशन। विदाउट वेस्टिंग एनी टाइम लेट्स बिगिन।
द थ्री प्रोसेस इन लेजर, दैट इज स्टिमुलेटेड एब्सॉर्प्शन, स्पॉन्टेनियस इमिशन एंड द स्टिमुलेटेड इमिशन and the stimulated emission. So topic to be covered: laser, a chronic terminated absorption, spontaneous emission and its characteristic stimulated emission and its practices. Laser, a chronic, the word laser is an acronym for light amplification by stimulated emission of radiation. So as the name suggests, in laser the light is amplified with the help of a process called stimulated emission. Therefore laser is based on the principle of the stimulated emission. In other words, it is a device to produce a monochromatic beam, lightly intense and covalent beam of light. Stimulated absorption: when a photon of light having energy E2 minus E1, that is equal to h into nu, where nu is frequency of radiation, is incident on an atom in ground state. The ground state E1 may absorb the photon and jump to the higher energy state. Helium He do this process is called as stimulated absorption or induced absorption. This is called as, because the incident photon has stimulated the atom to absorb the energy, because we are providing external energy and that external energy is absorbed by the atom in the ground state, and this atom will be excited to the upper state. With a help of absorption of this external energy, that's why the name is stimulated absorption. Spontaneous emission: now the excited atom in the excited state automatically decays to ground state by emitting a photon of energy E2 minus E1 equal to h nu. That this process is gradient spontaneous emission. Generally an atom or electron in excited state and can state for 10 raised power minus 9 to 10 minus 8 seconds. So here, where spontaneous mean by its own emission means to emit the energy. So the excited electron or atom will be the excited to the ground state by its own after approximately 10 days to 10 raised to power minus 8 second. This process is known as spontaneous emission. Characteristic of spontaneous emission: the emitted photon of energy E2 minus E1 equals to h nu can move in any random direction. There will not be any phase. The relationship between the photons emitted from various atoms has the relations coming out due to spontaneous emission are in covariant, and the reason the spontaneous emission cannot be the principle of laser. Stimulated emission: if the atom is in excited state E2 as it was in the previous diagram, we have this curve and a photon of energy exactly equal to E2 minus E1 equal h nu is incident on it. Then the incident photon interact with the atom in the excited state, and then it stimulate or induces the atom to come down the ground state E1. A fresh photon is emitted in this process. Therefore, when an atom eject a photon due to its interaction with the photon incident on it, the process is called as stimulated emission. Induced emission: you can see in this diagram that a photon exactly equal E2 minus E1 incident on system and excited atom exit in the system. for exciting electron exit in the system, and this proton will interact with this excited atom, and it will induce this excited atom or electron to be excited to the ground state, and the incident photon and the photon released during the excitation from E2 to E1, these two photons will move in the same action. So practice 6 of the molecular emission, for each incident photons there are two outgoing photons moving in the same direction as the emitted photon, has exactly the same energy phase interaction as an incident photon. We will achieve an amplified and undirectional coherent beam. The laser is based on the principle of stimulated emission.